Yo, this is Grandmaster Turntablist Disc, and you gotta watch Pyramind on YouTube. You know why? Because I said so.
Hey, I'm Jeff Straw with Pyramind. Really excited today to have with us a legend on the turntables, Turntablist Disc. He's gonna drop some serious science for us. Really kind of wanted you to just jump in and do your thing over some beats. Have some fun, go crazy, do what you do, right? And then after that, maybe we'll break some things down, have you talk through some of your scratches, and educate the fine people of the internet land on breaking a few things down on how you do what you do. Sound good?
Sounds good.
If you're not familiar with Turntablist Disc, give us the quick one too. Founding member.
Invisible Scratch Pickles, Praxis, Bill Laswell, Herbie Hancock, Tabla Beat Science, etc.
Do you really have to say anything after Bill Laswell?
Buckethead,
right?
Primus.
So, yeah, it's an honor to have you here, man. Like, really, truly.
Thank you.
A big fan of all of that music through all of those iterations. So, it's cool, man. Thanks for coming
Thank
in.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. So, without further ado, really, I'm going to get out of the way. Just let him do his thing. What's the track you're going to play over a Tabla Beat Science track,
yeah,
right?
Tabla Beat Science is from their first album, so okay. It's an instrumental track, and this is what I usually cut to when I'm live with them, so I figure I'd cut over an instrument.
There we go. We just don't have Zakir here, but otherwise,
yeah.
we get him in spirit, and we get you on the decks.
Yeah,
cool, man. Like, have some fun.
All right. We'll be right back. me, when I perform, I've always used the same tools of scratching, which is, to me, is transforming, flaring, cutting and scratching, obviously just basic scratching, and crab. And basically, I mix those up with how I feel at the moment with the music. So, for instance, like, since this is such a solo, usually I'll start off with, I usually cut actually with the turntable off. For me, I scratch with the turntable off because I have more control. Because if you notice, if you have the turntable on, it just keeps on going. But if you have it off, you can go low or you can go high. See? I think I'm probably the only one that kind of does this. But I usually start with the platter off. Usually I'll start off with sort of like a, which is kind of a chirp, but usually I'll go forward. It's like a forward chirp. So usually what I'll do is I'll do a chirp with the transform, you know, and or else I'll just I'll speed it up with my thumb, which I use for speed when I'm have the platter off. So I'll start off with like. So basically all I did was just chirps and transforming, or if I have the platter on, I'll just. So that's just basically transforming. Or you can go, which is my style, it's kind of like a flare chirp. But it basically, when I start off a scratch, it basically depends on the music. Basically, let's say, for instance, when I tour with Herbie, it's a totally different feel from if I tour with Primus. You know what I mean? It's like a different duel. Or if I'm dueling with Les Claypool or Zakir, totally different accent or how I express myself at the moment with the scratching. But usually something freestyle, like there's a big connection to me with percussion and scratching. So I treat the scratch actually as a percussion instrument. So I'll just go into like a sort of a tabla style, like. And I just keep on just changing my style, and if the speed is on, there's a lot of scratches. When I look at some of the videos, I notice that there's a lot of like 3,000 scratches invented or something like that. And for me, honestly, I think those are just people's personalities, because you got the slowest scratch invented to the fastest. I mean, you can't go any faster than crab unless you're completely high on some. It's just your fingers going like this constantly. And I used to actually have finger weights that I used to practice with before I went to the crab, so I was able to kind of do this, go backwards, and basically the whole technique basically is to cover every area of the fader as much as possible, instead of transforming. So if you transform, there's a lot of gaps in that transforming, so crabbing basically took care of all that, so now. So basically just crabbing is basically just a rotation of your fingers going back and forth. And you can use it in many different ways. So, you know, just basically that's basic. And the idea too came from, I had an imagination because I created the crab. So my idea was I imagined 1 million San Francisco crabs, Dungeness crabs, clapping at the same time. So that's how the crab became to be called the crab, because of the actually Dungeness crab imagination in my head. So it kind of sounded like that. So everybody knows this actually. I created that technique. That technique was, the first time it was ever used was in the 1991 Kubert's DMC. I was at his house and I was scratching on the 18, he owned the 1800 Newmark. And I was scratching on his, on one of the clickers, because the faders on the Newmark obviously were stiff as hell. Whoever knows a Newmark back in the 80s. So I was scratching on the clicker, and I was scratching on It's Time, Al Nafish, and So I'm just in my zone scratching, and right as I'm getting to the breakdown when I want to, you know, tear it up, the clicker breaks off. I'm like, oh shit! And just to not lose that moment, I for some reason the closest thing was the up fader, and the up fader was really stiff. So to me, it's actually been it's been really hard to duplicate that moment that I did with the fader. But I actually created the most perfect echo scratch you can think of, and that's how I came up with it. So basically, the speed of its time actually is what, 110, 120 BPM, so I'm really going at a good speed. So as soon as that broke off, I try to go. But instead, I created, so basically, instead of wanting to scratch like I just did, it didn't come out like that. The pressure of my fingers was going so fast and hard to the fader that actually created a perfect da 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 da. So that's how the fader was moving, da 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 da. And with the it sound, it made it go, and I was like, whoa, that's so cool. And so I just started messing with it, and I just. And I told Cuber to do it in his 1981 DMC. So if you see it, he's doing it on Public Enemy. Yeah, boy. That was the very first time ever it was done live with anyone. So yeah, I created that in 1990, 91. That everybody does, and everybody does the orbit. But that's off the flare, which is the flare scratch, but the orbit is basically two clicks forward, two clicks back, and you're basically just it's just a 1-2 click, 1-2, 1-dun, da-dun, 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 da-dun. So that's the orbit scratch off the famous flare scratch, which was invented by Flare. But that's another popular scratch that everybody does nowadays, is the orbit. There's also the phaser scratch. We used to do this a lot, which was, we sort of do it once in a while, but it's like, basically a grab a long tone. You can actually do it on short sounds, which I'll show you. But it's a long tone. So you can do that. You can do it on short sounds. So this is a short sound, it's not a tone, but you can do it on these too. The only difference, you have to rotate your finger, your hands on this side in order to make it come back, because you can't go forward all the time. That's the idea, you know. I'm holding the platter. I do this because I either hold the platter and the record at the same time, or just hold the platter. But for now, as you can see, I was just holding the platter. If it goes, you know, you can't. It'll lose the. But you can also create something new by having it on. I think I just created something right there. There you go. I just created something right there. No. But yeah, but I think most, it would be more effective if you want to use short sounds when the platter's off. Because like I said, for me, I don't know anyone that does it, that scratches with the platter off. So for me, with the platter off, you have more control, and basically all your power comes from your thumb. So if you want to move the motor, you move the motor with your thumb. So this is the rotation you want to have. It's like this. You're controlling the vinyl, and you're controlling the speed of the turntable at the same time. So basically you're the power and the control. And for me, I find it very effective, especially if you're playing with a band, because you can switch very fast. Here you have to press the button still, but here you have full control. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you can just go crazy and do whatever you want. And then there's this thing. I'm not sure what I should call this, but... So I've had this record for so long, it's the original Toasted Marshmallow Free, but I've had it so long that one day it broke off. I was like, what the hell am I gonna do now? Like, but then one day I was realized, you know what? What if I do this? It actually worked. I have no name for it yet, but basically you're rotating the sound back and forth. Causes a sort of a bowl effect. So this is how it would sound if it was just no. You can go, you can do all sorts of stuff. And I also did, you can also use your thumb too as well. I started using it. So I'm still experimenting with it actually. So I've started to actually do all kinds of stuff. So it's still in the early process, but this is one of my sort of newest invention things that I've been toying with. So, but there's been a lot more stuff that I've been involved in scratching, but those are kind of the main scratches that a lot of kids are doing nowadays that have been, you know, popularized. So, you know, yeah, among other things. So. We'll be right back.
If you're a music producer, subscribe to our channel and stay up to date on the latest Pyramind tutorial videos, track breakdowns, elite sessions, and more. Visit us at pyramind.com.